I stand up, I get up, I feel more in the corner. I will lose, I should lose a focus. I come on, be a good getter. I should not corner, I should not corner, I should not corner, I should not corner. Stay focused. Opportunities, you gotta get this, you gotta fight this deal.
We turn up on a Sunday, cause we're making more money on a Monday. I'm with hustlers on a Tuesday. Yeah, sure, but fair to all this meaning, Mbwele Ungapambili or SABC 1. Get to send me a Pimakaya and a salute to all my hustlers. Now, talk about their name, Mbwele Lishoma Uhlelo Ispani, where we invest excess in lentsha ekulelizwe bafethu. Speaking of which, kule viki ke sibheke ikhari babiza ngokuthi i-insurance assessor. But we're not just talking about any insurance. Sikhuluma ke ngomshwalensi wey'moto. Sihamba ne-hustler lethu uSimon Ngcobo osethando lwakhe ley'moto nokwenza iy'balo. Ke waphuma ke nomkhakha kungani ke insurance akehlale phansi since kuyazi kangcono ke insizwe njengoba sithi Simon Sabela ngoba uyabizwa ngithi hi Duma yatsamaya name Ntuduzi Simon Ngcobo age 26 education matric tertiary qualification NCV mechanical engineering
I think Simon is a very passionate person, fun, focus, enthusiast, and a good brother. Yes.
I like working with people, and I also like to respect other people, and even though I don't expect the same from them, but I just want them to treat me the same way I treat them. And also, I like to focus, to be focused. Like, don't lose control, because you know what happened? Most of people, when they get something like you earning more in whatever you're doing, they start losing control. I don't want that. I just want to stick in one place, to be focused, and to look after myself and my family. I grew up in Mpumalanga. There's a small village named Kwaggafontein. So it was me, my sister, my brother, my mother, and my grandfather. That time, I didn't know much about my father, so I only know that my grandfather was my father. Because you know, all the days they never told you who's your father, if your father is not there at the moment. Just to keep you happy. Like when you chat with your friends and they start chatting with about their fathers and everything, say, okay, my father is like this and that and that. At that time, it was difficult because sometimes you can see that, okay, they say this is my father, but even my mother keeps saying father to the person I call father sometimes. So it was, I always ask myself if, this is he really my father, or there is my father out there, you know? But sometimes my mother will tell me that, you know what, he is your father, because he's the one who looked after you since you were young. And I never asked much questions, because I was still young. I didn't want to cause conflict in the house. High school, I wanted to study mechanical engineering. I was more interested in fixing engines and know more about the engines of the vehicle. What happened is I was doing grade 12. My mother said to me, okay, you know what, we have to go and visit your other sister. So we went to Springs, and when we get to Springs, I saw that there was this other college named Ebulen East College. And I was interested because it was it's a nice college. And at the moment, I don't know if after my matric I'll go and study or what, because my mother, she's the only one working at home, and there's no one who can just send me to school. So I told my mother that, you know what, mom, after my matric, I just want to study mechanical engineering. And she said, okay, but you know, I don't have money to send you to school. And I said, okay, it's fine, but we can get inside the college just to ask, what do they want? Is it possible for me to get the bursary or one? We went there, Ewulen East College, and they said, okay, there are bursaries, but then first you have to send your matric results so that they can see if you can study mechanical engineering, or they will just have to check which course it will fit for you. After my matric, I went there. I managed to pass. I completed NQF level 4. Then it was a national certificate, you know. And I went to apply to other companies for internship. So I did go for various interviews, assessments and all that, but I never get opportunity to be selected so that I can join them to study whatever I want to study, because actually I always want to proceed with this mechanical engineering thing, get more experience, because at college, you know, we do a theory, so I wanted to know more about practical. So I never got into any internship.
He's come far, he's come a long way, and I think he's going far. It doesn't end here, he's still going far. Tomorrow he's going for an interview at Santam. He's been waiting for this opportunity, and I hope it goes well. I hope they see his enthusiasm and passion, and big ups.
Yes, we're still moving pace, because we are boss buffets when it comes to getting those jobs. You can teach us how to get umuntu ke azenzela. Sonke singavumelana ukuthi uSimon inqola yakhe isiyaduma njengoba ke afuna ukwengena kulo mkhakha. Asimbone lapha na ku interview, but I got a hunch that he's gonna do well.
Good morning, Simon.
Morning, morning.
Welcome to the interview at Santam Insurance.
Thank you.
Just a brief background regarding Santam's history in the insurance.
Yes.
Santam being the largest insurer in South Africa, with a national footprint of 22%, and has paid out more than 99% of its claims.
Okay.
Okay, Simon, you went through the whole training process.
Yes.
Spanned over about 30 months now. First 12 months being your introduction into the velveting environment and spray painting and all of that. You did your NQF level 2 automotive body refinisher.
Yes, yes.
That completed, and then we did that 4 skills programs on NQF level 3 and 4, and addition a couple of 5s on the mechanical section. So Simon, how did you find all of the training? How do you feel? How did you experience it?
At the beginning, it was really tough because I didn't know anything about body parts of the vehicle. So they had to taught us how to identify various parts of the vehicle. During the training, it was not that easier to understand how to repair body parts. So there was a mentor there who was assisting us just to check how to do the job during the training process.
And you guys had to keep a portfolio of evidence?
Yes, we did compile a portfolio of evidence to make sure that when you go for assessment, they know that you did other part, you did work on them, and other part you did not work on them. So they will understand if they do assessment, they won't just want you to like work on the stuff that you didn't do at the body shops. Maybe if you were preparing small dent at the body shop, they'll make sure that you do that assessment and you find competent. Sure.
What was your former work experience prior to finding Santam?
Actually, I was at college. I was studying mechanical engineering. So on my existing level, I had to apply in various companies for internship. And I would go for interviews and assessments, but I don't know whether it was backlash or what, I was not appointed. So I saw the post on the internet that Santam are looking for learners to train them to become assessors. At the time, I didn't know anything about becoming an assessor, and I didn't know what is an assessor about. But when I checked on the post, I saw that, okay, they are talking about the vehicles and all that, and I was interested from day one, because I'm the guy who's always interested in knowing what's happening with the vehicles, what makes the vehicle to function and all that. So I thought it was all about mechanical. So that's when I applied to Santam.
If you do get appointed at Santam, will this be your first full-time job?
Yes, yes.
So Simon, having all of that completed, all of your training, your internship, what's your expectations going forward?
All I want is to work for Santam, become an assessor, to make sure that I'm helping the company to achieve more in future. I want to become the member of the companies. We just want to see the company grow bigger and bigger.
Part of the family.
Yes.
All right. Going forward now, the next step would be your exposure in the environment of an assessor, doing the job really. So you'll be exposed to three job roles, tasks for the assessor. First one being light damage, but all of them will consist of establishing the actual value of the damaged vehicle's repair, negotiating that with the repairer of choice, and then communicating with the client and his or her broker, and then obviously closing the loop by authorizing and giving the necessary information through to everyone. Having said that, there's a bit more serious level on where the vehicle is either stolen or written off, which means it's uneconomical to repair. All right, which you've been exposed to by the examples and training. And maybe you can explain to me slightly on how you remember how to do vehicles that are uneconomically repairable.
Firstly, you have to know if the vehicle is insured under Santam. You have to go through the policy schedule of the vehicle just to check how much was the vehicle insured for. How much does the vehicle cost at the moment? So once you do that, you have to start with your assessment on the vehicle just to check how much will the parts cost to repair the vehicle. You have to know the labor, you have to know the painting. If you can estimate, it's going to be easier for you, because you can say that, okay, this vehicle, for example, cost for 40,000. And I have to make sure that I don't exceed the amount of 20,000, because if I exceed that amount, the repair figure is almost 25,000 or 30,000, then the vehicle is going to be a write-off.
Okay, so what's going to happen is now, like Zaid mentioned, we're going to allocate a mentor to you. His name is Lucas. And you'll work under Lucas for the remainder of the period until we've deemed you fit to fulfill that role totally on your own. So you'll start off working under coaching with a mentor until he feels you are equipped to carry on your own and just under supervision. And then the evaluation will take place. And then after evaluation, we'll leave you on your own, so to speak, to carry on and do assessments. And we'll evaluate from a distance. And once we're happy with your progress, then we'll sit around the table again.
Supile di challenges tse a kopaneng le tsona go training ya hae empa ha a bua ka se a ithutileng sona o buile handle ka dikgatlhego tsa gae tsa mechanical empa ha a di kopanya le mosebetsi ona e leng wa assessor. Mahaslase, pele o ya ko interview, tseba ka tsamaiso ya mosebetsi ya tsatsi le tsatsi. Buisana le batho ba e leng gore ba etsa mosebetsi o gore ba tsebe go o eletsa. Simon yena o tswa gole. Ha o ka tobana le bophelo ba hao o shebile gore bo be bonolo, ha di challenges ditla, di tla o tlhola. Empa ha o ka amogela di challenges di teng le bophelo ba hao bo tla ba bonolo. Ha re khutla, re fumana go gongata ka training ya Simon le lefapha lena la short term insurance.
Sister,
Hustlers, zonke sike sasizwa ke inganekwane eshow abantu ke bese bafuna uclaim for umshwalensi. Omunye wathi, I didn't see the tree, it just stepped in front of the car. Yeah, right. Clearly you were not driving a smart car. Kodwa ke kunabantu ke abama insurance assessor njengoba Simon abasicishwe ukuthi umkhonyo obunje ngalo awusebenzi. Into sifuna ukuyazi ukuthi yini ke engakudonsa ukuthi ungene kulomkhakha. Ngithi ake sithole ulwazi khona laphana ku sector overview. Asise short left singene ku information highway.
Imisebenzi nje oyaziyo ukuthi ngumsebenzi ama clients angeke ajabulele ukukubona njengalomsebenzi wokuba insurance assessor abakhethwa yinkampani zama insurance ukuthi bayobheka umonakalo ovelele ama clients azo ukuthi ngabe uyahambelana yini nemali abafisa ukusizwa ngayo kule ikhalo zabo. Njela babantu basebenza ukubhekisisa ukuthi ngabe imoto elimele ingakhona ukulungiswa nobecha nokuthi futhi ilimele kangakanani nokuthi kungaba yiziphi indlela ezimelula zokuyilungisa. Lokhu kungaba umuzi, ibhizinisi noma imoto elimele, zonke izizodinga i-assessor enolwazi olubanzi mayelana nalolo hlobo lalokho okulimele. Indlu elimele, i-assessor kumele iye lapho kuleyo ndlu iyobheka umonakalo ukuthi ngabe unganani. Isangotho, ikhukhula nokunyakaza komhlaba noma ukuqhoma kwamaphayiphi kungenza umonakalo omkhulu, bese kuthi zona imoto ezidulile ezilimele zingabiza imali eningi ukuzilungisa. Iinkampani eziningi zama-insurance zinikeza ukufundela kuzona okuhambisana nemithetho lapho kuphethwe khona iinkampani zama-insurance eNingizimu Afrika. Kodwa ulwazi lona uzoluthola uma ususebenza. Yileyo naleyo assessor iqondana nalowo msebenzi awazi kangcono. Njengokuthi nje i-assessor yezindlu kumele iqondisise kahle iindlela zokwakha neindleko zakhona. Ngakho, uma ungumuntu onolwazi lokwakha noma useke wasebenza emsebenzini wokwakha, ungakhona ukuba neso elikhaliphile kulo msebenzi. Kodwa ke, i-assessor ibhekana nezikhalo zokulimala kweimoto noma ukuntshontshwa yona akudingi ukufundela okunganani, kodwa ke kudinga ube ngumuntu osanelwazi lawo lo msebenzi. Njengoba nawe uyibonela ukuthi imoto siseziningi emgwaqweni, lokho ngokuyasho ukuthi cha, sisazodinga ama-assessor amaningi ngempela.
Training ya lefapha lena o ifumana go tswa go mohiri. The insurance company ka bongata di offer in-service training for the assessor le di exam tse e neng gore di beilwe ke Insurance Institute of South Africa. Bokgoni le botsebi ba mosebetsi o bo fumana teng mosebetsing. Go go tsho gore ga o se o le qualified, ga o tlhoke certificate kapa formal qualification.
I think it's time for you to manage. Ukuthi senze kanje sike lomntanazi abafethu sambeni so spana. So bona uSimon nge ashaya task yakhe yokuqala abafethu. Insizwa ithi intswe ngokushaya le spana abafethu. Ngabe ke iya claim. See what I just did there? Claim insurance. And that's why I'm not a comedian, I'm just a presenter. Or am I? Asambeni ke so bona uSimon umuntu osho ngale nto ke afuna kuyenza njengoba ke azoqala uku assessa. Yuthi snap. I hope that link was insured.
My name is Lucas Rana Mane. I'm from Esteros and I'm 26 years old and I'm a motor assessor for Santam. I started working as a motor assessor now, it's close to a year now. I've been in the industry for close to 4 years. Firstly started off as a panel beater / spray painter so that you can acquire the qualifications to become an assessor. Hi Simon, welcome to the driving center. This is task one. You are about to do a merit report on the accident. Just look at the damage and then see what the damage cause was. After the report, we will do an assessment. You'll just bring forth the information and then we'll put it into the auto pad and then process the assessment. You got any questions?
Okay, can I ask you something?
Yes.
Once the vehicle comes in here, or once the client comes in, must I ask the client about the full incident description or what?
The full incident description. You might find accident damage that they did not see.
Okay.
Okay. A motor assessor, in a nutshell, would be the person who looks at the damage on your vehicle and then assesses the damage and tell you the value that it's going to be to repair the vehicle. What a motor assessor would basically need to do, he would first need to have panel beating experience. Either panel beating or become an estimator for a panel shop to do assessments. He can also go and venture into becoming a spray painter to have those qualifications to become an assessor.
Welcome to Santam Province, ma'am. I'm the assessor going to assist you.
Okay.
So, ma'am, can you walk around your vehicle so that you can show me the damage?
All right.
We have two different type of assessors, actually. We have digital assessors, we have a mobile or assessors that are working at the driving center. The digital assessors, they are the one that is going to do the assessment through the photos. They don't go and physically inspect the vehicle. They just do the assessment through the photos and quotation that they've received from the panel beater. And they call the panel beater to discuss the quotation, phone the client to confirm that discussion has been made with the panel beater, authorization has been given. The mobile assessors, those are the ones who go and physically assess the vehicle. Once they're done with the assessment, they just send authorization for repairs.
I was parking by the mall, and then when I come out, I found out that my door was like this.
So this was the only damage on the vehicle?
Yes.
Okay, ma'am. There was any witnesses who show what happened to your vehicle? Did anyone come to you maybe just to tell you that another vehicle was here or what happened?
Actually, I could ask the people that look for the cars, but there was no one who was telling me what happened exactly.
Which mall was that, ma'am?
It was by Colonnade Mall.
Colonnade Mall. So did you maybe try to phone the police just to open up a case or what?
No, I didn't.
You didn't open up the case?
No.
Oh, so did you discuss the claim with your broker?
Yes, I did.
Okay, ma'am. No problem.
As an assessor, I think you should firstly be confident in what you're doing. In terms of your negotiation skills, you should be able to negotiate and come to an agreement with the client and the broker in terms of the repairs that are going to be done on the vehicle.
Okay, I also got another damage here when I was reversing by my gate in the morning and then I hit the pole here on this area.
Okay, were you at your home or what?
Yes, I was by my house and going out.
All right, ma'am. So I see there's also light scratches on the vehicle. What happened with the light scratches? Did they happen during the car wash or what?
No, these other ones are the old things that happened. They didn't happen to the accident.
Okay, ma'am, what I'll do is I'll start with the assessment on the vehicle. Then once I'm done with the assessment and I've discussed it with the panel beater, I'll give you the full details what's going to happen with the repairs. Are we going to replace the door or are we going to repair the door of the vehicle?
Maybe how long is it going to take?
Okay, ma'am, I can say 20 to 30 minutes. Then I'm going to give you feedback about everything.
All right, thank you.
Okay, thank you. In task one, everything went well because I didn't have much conflict with the client. Officially, the client did understand whatever I'm telling her about the damages on her vehicle.
Well, in task one, he did fairly good. He showed that he knows what he's been trained to do as a motor assessor.
Bokgoni ba go sebedisana le batho le go rarolla mathata ke dilo tse botlhokwa gape tse tlhokagalang mesebetsing ya rona e mengata. Seo o lokela go seetsa ka go supa client gore o utlwisisa bothata ba gae, o ikemiseditse go mo thusa ka gotlhe empa ka tlase ga molao o leng teng. Gopola gore na le mefuta e mebedi ya di-assessor. Mofuta wa pele ke mofuta o e leng gore o hirilwe go tswa ka ntle empa o offere di-services to di-insurance company kapa di-broker. mofuta wa bobedi ke o hirileng ke insurance company. Ha re khutla ka morama bengele, re latela Simon Hansa yetsa di policy checks tsa hae, Mac o re tlela le Ispani Q ya beke ena. Ha re kopane ka mora sena.
Siphele isikhathi sokudlala bafethu, isikhathi sokulala nesikhathi sokuphathwa indlala. So isikhathi manje siphande bafethu sihamba naye uSimon umfoka Ngcobo ofuna ukuba insurance assessor njengoba laphana eSantam azongena ku-second phase ye-task yakhe laphana ye-claim assessment. Speaking about assessments, let me assess your brains khona laphana kwi-Spani Q sethu sakule viki bafethu. Umbuzo wethu uhamba kanje, I go up when the rain comes down, what am I? I go up when the rain comes down, what am I? Ngithi don't be left in the rain, bafethu. Thumela kumchaphazo okukhulu shesha, uyazi uthini, hashtag Ispani with the capital Q, bese ungena laphana ku-social platforms zethu ufake eyakho impendulo. Kodwa khona manje sami sobona uSimon under the umbrella of Santa.
Okay, Simon, this is task two. We are about to do an assessment. Here's the order pad. I'm sure you know how to use this because you've been trained to do this. Okay, let's move around the vehicle. Please ensure that when you put in the information, you get the registration number, the VIN number, and the oil damage of the vehicle. Get the direction of the damage when you do the assessment as well.
Okay.
The time period to do an assessment basically is in between 15 minutes and 20 minutes depending on the questions that the client would ask themselves as well.
VIN.
Okay, the challenges in this environment is to, like, for you to go to another level, because you have to work hard from where you at the moment before you can get to another level. Because for this company, everything goes with grades, and you can't just go to another grade without showing commitment in what you're doing for this company.
Flips, okay. Remove the mud flaps. You have to remove the window.
Well, the industry of insurance, I think it's a very lucrative and very open. It's exciting. It doesn't keep you confined to only one thing. There's always challenges every day to make you a better person. There's a lot of growth. You can become an assessor firstly, and then from there you become an assessor's manager, and then the sky is the limit after that.
Okay, lights crashes on the vehicle. Okay.
In regards to motor assessing, it doesn't only make you confined to only working with vehicles. There's also watercraft, aircraft assessors, and then heavy haulage assessors. That would be the guys who assess trucks, and that comes with experience when you start at the ground levels as a motor assessor.
Bridges. Let me write on the note. Let's bridges on the leg. Switches. The thing apart
task due is, it's because of task due, it's challenging because you have to know how long will it take to repair that kind of a dent on the vehicle. And you have to know whether we can repair the door or we have to replace it. So it's challenging because you can decide to repair the door, but once you discuss the quotation with the estimator will come with another idea to say, no, we can't repair the door because of 1, 2, 3. Just done with the assessment on the vehicle.
Okay. Okay, that's fine. We're gonna process all this information.
Bona gore go ba assessor o tlhoka technical knowledge o lokela go bana le elehloko ka se o se shebileng o lokela go bana le litlho la go bona tseo ka ofela o di fumana ko training e o tla ietsang mahaslase go betere gore o bane le discomfort empa o yetsa dilo tse ileng gore di tla huisa go ditoro tsa hao gona le gore o bane comfortable ka go sietse letho Simon o saletse ke task ya go qetela Mac yena o re tlisetsa karabo ya Ispani Q dula le rona Zanonke we mahaslas nizoqasha phansi kweumbrella eSpain bafethu njengoSimon Ngobo ayenzile njengoba alaphana eSantam afuna ukubona ukuthi yonke le minyaka ayichithile aloba afunda ngabe ke investment yakhe is going to pay out but I see you you're wilding out khona laphana ku social media bafethu with your answer so let me help you out ngimphinele umbuzo wethu sithe I go up when the rain comes down what am I ngithi let's make it rain laphana ku Twitter bafethu with your answers ngithi khona manje ngithi poof be gone Asam sobona ukuthi uSimon is keep on.
Okay,
how are you?
Good day, Rudolf.
Can't complain.
It's Simon.
Rudolf, nice meeting you.
Okay, Rudolf, I'm here regarding that vehicle for Mr. Ngoza.
Yes.
Yes. So what we can do is we have to discuss this quotation because I'm done with the assessment on the vehicle.
No, certainly.
Okay, no problem. Okay, so what I've decided to do is to replace that left rear door because I see it's badly damaged. And I'll allow for blending on the left front door and the left rear fender of the vehicle.
Yes.
So there is a slight damage on the seal.
Okay.
Cell panel of the vehicle. So what I'll do is I'll give you 2.5 hours to repair that cell
panel. And I'll need more than 2 hours on that repair.
Need more than?
I'll need more. I'll need at least about 6 hours for repair on that cell panel.
Okay, but the thing is, I've taken a look at the cell panel. It's not the major job to do on that cell panel.
If you look at the area where it's damaged, as I said, six is a fair amount for the repair there.
Six. Okay, what we can do is, because of six is too much for me, I cannot allow for much labor. Instead of six, we can go up to 3. We can just agree on 3 hours to repair it.
3 hours sounds reasonable. 3 hours is reasonable. We can work on that.
Okay, then I'll allow for 3 hours to repair the cell panel.
Okay.
And I'll allow for a stone chip protector on that cell panel.
Yes, that's fine. So we're going for a new door on the back?
Yes.
And then a repair on the left cell panel?
Yes, we'll do so.
If you want to become a motor assessor, it would be you taking an internship in an insurance company whereby they could teach you and give you all the trades to become a motor assessor. There's no major qualification. As long as you know the repair process of repairing a car and being able to estimate accurately.
And another thing I want to confirm to you, I saw that there is a pre-damage on the back of the vehicle, like the tailgate of the vehicle, and there's slight scratches on the back bumper.
Okay. And that's not related to the incident?
They're not related to the incident, and I'm going to discuss them with the client.
Okay.
To confirm to the client that another claim is to be open for another for those damages on the vehicle.
So the customer will be aware of that that's not covered in the same claim?
Yes, I'm going to do so. So what I'll do now is, since we've agreed on the repairs on the vehicle, I'm going to send authorization for repairs.
Okay.
Then you guys will phone the client once you receive all the parts. to confirm when to bring in the vehicle for repairs.
That's fine. Yeah, as I said, the mounts, everything is fine. I'm fully happy with the labor. And yeah, as soon as we receive a confirmation regarding authorization, we'll be in contact with the customer and we'll make the necessary arrangements.
Okay, thank you, Rodolfo.
Thank you.
I think it's a major role to know the repair process of the vehicle before you becoming an assessor. Because the assessor, once you become an assessor, you have to understand if you communicating with the panel beater or discussing the quotation with the panel beater, you have to understand that why do I give them this labor? It's because of you know the process of the repair. Why do I give them this 20 working unit or 2 hours to repair this door? Why do I give them blending? Why do I not give them blending? Because in most cases, we'll fight about the blending and the labor to do the repairs on the vehicle.
What is blending?
Okay, ma'am, I'm done with the assessment on your vehicle and I've discussed the quotation with Rudolph, the estimator from this panel shop. So what we'll do is, ma'am, we'll send authorization for replacement on the left rear door. But then the damage is on the back of the vehicle, the tailgate and the back bumper. It's another incident, so there have to be another claim launched for those damages because they are not accident related on this claim.
But why? It happens on the same day, Moss.
Yes, ma'am, it's the same day, but separate incident. So it's a protocol that all assessors must follow to make sure that if there's 2 separate incidents on the claim, then we have to open another claim because we cannot handle them on the same claim.
So is there any extra cost that will be included on?
There won't be any extra cost, ma'am, because what I check here, when I see on your policy schedule, you don't have any excess. So there will be nil excess on both of the claim.
Oh, okay, all right. Then why are you not replacing my door and repairing, because that door is damaged so bad?
No, we're not going to repair it, ma'am, actually. We're going to replace it.
Oh, okay, then yes. Thank you if it's like that.
Okay, thank you, ma'am. Anything you'd like to know?
I'd like to know the process. How long is it going to take to fix my car? Because I don't have a kayaha or something, so.
All right, ma'am. What we'll do is, I've discussed it with Rudolph. Rudolph will wait for parts before they confirm to you when to bring in the vehicle for repairs. So once they've received the parts, they can organize the courtesy car for you. You'll discuss it with them because I see on your policy schedule, you don't have any rental car or car hire.
Yes.
So you'll discuss it with them how to make payments for that courtesy car.
All right.
Okay, ma'am.
That's all, ne?
Okay, thank you, ma'am.
Thank you very much.
Today, everything went well. We've managed to work with the client and the claim from starting to the end without any conflict that includes management and other people, like the people who are above the manager.
I think Simon is fit for this job and he has a lot of room for growth and he can become the best assessor in the country.
Esikopini sethu sakule viki of who wants to be a hustler. Simbuzileke umbuzo ohamba kanje. I go up when the rain comes down. What am I? Is it A, an umbrella? B, a bird? C, a cat? Or D, a dog? And the answer is A, an umbrella. Because some of you got it wrong and some of you got it right. And you win absolutely nothing but a pat on the back. On that note, Bafethu, we'll be back after the break. But right now, let's check out some ads and maybe we'll be lucky to get some insurance ads.
So Simon, you spend your time at the driving center. How did you experience that?
At the driving center, I've just experienced how the client gets angry over a small thing. Like the client will fight for a thing that you can see that it's not even part of the claim. But then on the other side, to discuss the claim with the client, it's a nice thing because they get to understand what you guys are going through during the repair process of the vehicle, and they get to understand better what's the process from the start till the end.
Oh, that's good. And we got some very good feedback from your mentor, Lucas, regarding the way you handle clients and the whole claim process. From a training point of view, I'm very satisfied with what perspired. Couple of pointers that came out was, as you know, mentioned at the beginning, a bit of conflict handling. One thing to just be wary of, something to work on, would be not to give in too soon to a client's demands, just for the sake of avoiding a bit of conflict. It is difficult, you deal with that every day, but I promise you, as soon as you get the hang of it, it makes your life a lot easier. Because if you give in today, tomorrow you want that again. But having said that, I think the progression so far was brilliant. You exceeded my expectations that I had. Going forward, I would like to see you develop to perhaps move on forward in a higher responsibility environment, perhaps a bit of exposure in the mobile area, but that we can discuss at a later stage.
Okay.
Once you've proven yourself in the driving center environment, there is room for growth, and that's being promoted to a mobile assessor. That's going out to all the towing yards and doing vehicles that are non-drivable, that are more excessive damage. Right. After being a mobile assessor, you can obviously specialize in heavy haulage or motor vehicles. And once you're there, the opportunities are endless. You can branch off into management as well, senior management, regional management, and sky's the limit.
When I was at the Digital Hub during the training, I heard that they were talking about the write-off vehicle, but most of the client during the, let's say the hail, there's a hail damages on the vehicle. And most of the client will say, but I want to keep my vehicle because of this engine of the vehicle is still new. So I prefer to keep my vehicle and fix it myself. How do you deal with that claims?
If the client pressurizes, not pressure, if a client wants to retain his vehicle and he doesn't want it written off, he can do that under circumstances that he's the full owner of the vehicle, title holder and owner of the vehicle, and there's no higher purchase involved, there's no bank. That's the only time, and obviously we can then see what was the repair threshold on the vehicle and what's your current quotation to repair that vehicle. And cash would be granted to the client as a settlement of his claim, and the vehicle needs to be then repaired and brought back to the driving center for an inspection to see if the repairs were done according to quality and spec, so we can reinsure that vehicle on the same policy.
Just to add to Zaid, but going forward, it is company policy, when you progress, you will get all the appropriate training from the technical guys. That's us, our environment. So we will never throw you in the deep end. So as soon as you are ready for progression to a next level, doesn't matter if it's mobile or if it's specialization in watercraft or vehicles, heavy haulage, we'll supply and put you through the necessary training to enable you to answer all of those difficult questions.
Okay, okay.
Any other questions?
No question.
Simon, well done. You've come through the ranks. You've shown you can do the job. You're enthusiastic and motivated, which I like. You will be employed at the market-related cost to company salary, and you'll be working at the drive-in center to get more experience in the trade.
And as soon as you pass that, and you worked your specific time at the drive-in center and proved your worth a bit more, then it's going to be open for you going forward. So congratulations, Simon.
Okay, thank you guys for good news. Thank you. Hello, everyone. Whoever is watching there, I just want to tell you that, guys, if you are there at home and ufuna ukuphumelela in life, you don't have to give up. You have to have hope in whatever you're doing. Believe in yourself. And whatever uyenza ngicela uyithathe serious, utshele ukuthi one day I'll make it. I'll become whatever I want to be or whoever I want to be. It's your choice. On that note, Pressa, Pusha, Panda.
Well done, Simone. O re rutile gore katlego ha e tle le fela. O lokela go emella, o sebetse gore o ifumane. Potso ya rona ya beke ena e tswa ko Jabu. A re yena o ithutela National Diploma in Human Resource. O batla go tseba gore ha se a qetile a nke mehato e feng. Jabu, batho ba HR ba netefatsa gore basebetsi ba bua puo e le nngwe le ba khamphane. Ba etsa seo ka go ba hira, ka go ba trainer le go ba tlhatlhola. Gore khamphane e atlege e tlhoka basebetsi ba tshwanetseng. Seo ke mosebetsi wa HR. O ka sebetsa ka go ba hira, o ka etsa training and development kapa o etsa administration ya di-policy tsa khamphane. Go fumana go gongata e kopanye le ba people management. Ha e ka ba gona le go sa o fumanang, gopola o check-ela Facebook kapa website ya rona. Re emetse tsa lona dipotso.
You need to invest in yourself and definitely it will pay dividends. Get it most misele pinde futhi uzinikela entweni bafethu. Ngithi sho uzofezekisa awakho amaphupho. Mina ngumfana kaMtambo ngidonza zonke intambo sengiphuma kanje. Ngithi hit us up on Twitter, Facebook and YouTube and also on Instagram. Do that victory pose and show us that you got a job. Or also hit us on our website bafethu. But until next week, get to remember, don't look down, cause hey, you might get into an accident. Get to look up and stay up. Swerve.